I'm Alex Tsai. The idea for the Nonfiction Minute popped into my head a few months ago. I called my friend and colleague Vicki Cobb right away to explain. Vicki, I said, the Common Core standards say that kids need to read a lot more nonfiction now, right?
Right!
Well, we write nonfiction for kids, but kids don't know where to find our work, and teachers don't even know we exist.
That's true.
Kids have to read a lot of boring textbooks, and teachers are overburdened with data collection, evaluations, test preparation, testing. When do they have the time to find quality nonfiction for their students?
That's a problem.
So here's the solution. It's a website called the Nonfiction Minute, with posts written by award-winning nonfiction authors. We'll make it available to teachers all over the world. Suddenly, kids will be reading great quality nonfiction every single day. Teachers can bring it up on their smart boards, they can use it as the do now, they can launch discussions and conversations, they can launch units on science, math, history, art, anything.
I love it!
Vicki was a teacher before she was a writer. So was I. My experiences as a teacher and a writer were the inspiration for the Nonfiction Minute. It's a really simple idea, but as William Golding, the author of Lord of the Flies, wrote, the greatest ideas are the simplest. So I hope you'll check out our simple idea. It's really simple to do. Go online at www.nonfictionminute.com. Check us out, and then come right back and meet Vicki.
I'm Vicki Cobb. I am president and founder of Ink Think Tank. We're bringing the Nonfiction Minute to you. If you've read it, I don't have to say anymore. You'll understand why the teachers that have written to us are so excited about the Nonfiction Minute. They can't wait for it to go live on September 8th. We can't bring the Nonfiction Minute to life without your help. We need funding to buy the rights to the minutes, to hire an editor, and to pay for the website. We hope you'll join us in spreading the word as well, because we think that the Nonfiction Minute, Alex's great idea, is a way to bring many voices from whom children can learn to the classroom every day. Who wouldn't want to read a Nonfiction Minute?